I'm Scott Jones, and I run a small nonprofit organization out of Kerrville, Texas. The acronym is PEACE Incorporated, and that stands for Peace and Emergency Action Coalition for Earth. And what I am primarily involved in is we've developed a program that is modeled on the Pentagon's war room and the software that they have to use that. I have worked in a number of war rooms in my 30-year naval career, and so I know how efficient this system can be. And so without asking, I have borrowed that model, and we have transformed it. The war room becomes the peace room, and we are developing software that we will give to any college or university that wants to use it. Anyone who is educated, at least in the Western tradition, knows the consequences of a superior technical culture impacting on another culture with less technology. The clash of cultures is just, it's the central theme of written history now. And the lower technical culture does not survive. And so anyone who thinks about this has to feel a little fear in their stomach, you know. So, you know, I think it is a very humane thing to do, to work to come up with a plan that will persistently introduce them to this potential of a time when we will meet another culture that is highly superior by a factor of what? 100,000?
Yeah, really.
Because they're 100,000 years older than we are.
Right.
And, you know, people might joke, well, why does that guy have such a big head? And the answer might be because his brain is so developed that it had to make room for him.
Yeah.
And think about that, you know. And but he doesn't talk. And we said, no, he doesn't talk. He doesn't have to. There is no need to talk when he can access your mind and get the feelings, and he can send his feelings to you. And that would be spooky. Werner von Braun brought that particular scenario up with a friend of mine that you know, he predicted that, you know, what would be the next big threats to bring up. And after terrorism, when that has played out, then it will be the threat from aliens. And so, you know, someone may want to play that card, but that's all the more reason for us to work hard now to bring disclosure up into the consciousness of people. I have a feel that there are some real buccaneers out there bopping around in the space, and they don't give a fig about things another. And so we need to be prudent, and when disclosure is formally made, the president or whomever makes it in this country needs to reassure the citizens, because just opening this up is going to open up a box that can never be closed.
Yeah,
and everybody will look at that box and see what they see. And some will see love and hope and relief from all sorts of problems, and others will see nothing but woe in there. But I think even the average person who's in the know knows this, that we are not spiritually ready to accept any of the important gifts that the visiting others could give us. We would destroy ourselves. And so, you know, we talk about the expectations from disclosure and contact. You know, just think of what would happen if they said, okay, here it is, guys, it's free energy, and we can package it this for the home and a larger package for the village, or, you know, it's a truck size for a city of a million. And just think of the potential impact. That would just devastate a huge part of our economy.
Absolutely.
Know, they would fight that tooth and nail.
Absolutely.
Know. Aside from anything to do with extraterrestrials, mm-hmm. we are in a very dangerous situation mm-hmm. on Earth. That we, with or without help from the visiting others, have developed a capability of destroying ourselves. And we've got to pull away from that and do it rapidly. and build in safeguards and get agreements that we will never cross that line again. And having done that, then we can consider, you know, take a deep breath and say, okay, that threat has gone away. What else do we need to attend to? Well, you know, we can't do these serially because these are going on concomitantly. We can't just do that and ignore what we're doing to our water and to our air. And so we've got to solve all these problems. But, you know, the basis for these problems, to me, the engine for that is the heart. We have to recognize that there's a good reason for doing this, and it's not selfish at all. It's because we owe it to ourselves and to our brothers and sisters. That just focuses brightly on the potential we have of losing it all, or the greater potential of solving these problems if we could, if we get our heart and say, you know, this is what we need to do. This is what we want to do for all the right reasons, because this will give my great-grandson a shot of living a beautiful life.